Our topic for discussion today is cultivation of sugar beet. Sugar beet or beetroot, also known by its colloquial name, beets or beta vulgaris, or chard or spinach beet, sea beet, garden beet, white beet, etc., is a sweet, healthy vegetable that belongs to Solanaceae family, which is loaded with antioxidants. It is actually these antioxidants packed inside beetroot's red pigments that contains cancer preventing and heart protecting properties. Beetroot is generally easy to grow and is consistently ranked as one of the top 10 vegetables grown in home gardens. Sugar beet is a tap-rooted crop and has a conical white fleshy root with a flat crown and a rosette of leaves. Although sugar is synthesized by photosynthesis in the leaves, it is stored in the root. Let's see about the origin and history of sugar beet. The wire ancestor or the progenitor of the sugar beet plant is the sea beet or the wild beet, that is Beta maritima. Sea beet is a type of wild plant mostly known for its foliage. Beetroot originated from Beta vulgaris species maritima by hybridization with Beta patula. Earlier types were with long roots, like that of carrot. Beetroot, sugar beet, and palak belongs to the species Beta vulgaris and are cross-compatible. The beetroot, a biennial plant, is a native to southern Europe. Sugar beet was introduced in India in the year 1950s. Now let's come to geographic distribution of sugar beet. Habitation is transcribed to the Mediterranean coast as well as the interior parts of Europe in the region of the Caspian and the Black Sea, the Atlantic coast of Europe and the islands close to Canary, Madeira and Balearic, etc. It is also to be noted that while beet has been classified by some taxonomist as a subspecies, that is maritima, of Beta vulgaris, France, the United States, Germany, Russia, and Turkey are the leading sugar beet producers in the world. In India, beetroot is mainly cultivated in Tamil Nadu, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, West Bengal, and Maharashtra. The total cultivated areas of beetroot in Tamil Nadu alone during 2011-12 was 1,116 in hectares. Let's come to soil and climatic requirement. Deep, well-drained loam or sandy loams is the best for beetroot cultivation. Heavy clayey soils result in poor germination and stand of the crop due to formation of soil crust after rains or irrigation. Roots may be misshaped and will not develop properly in heavy soils. The beetroot is highly sensitive to soil acidity and the ideal pH is about 6 to 7. Beetroot is one of a few vegetables which can be successfully grown in saline soils. It also grows well in sandy soils, on seashores, and is tolerant to excessive sodium. Beetroot prefers cool climate. Though it grows in warm weather, development of color, texture, sugar content, etc. of the roots is the best under cool weather. Extreme low temperature of 4.5 to 10 degrees Celsius for 15 days will result in bolting. It requires abundant sunshine for development of storage roots. All cultivars in beetroot are temperate biennial types and seed production is possible in the hills with 1,400 meter above mean sea level. A low temperature of 4.4 to 7.7 degrees Celsius for 6 to 8 weeks is required for flowers to initiate. Garden beet is a rather hardy crop and can tolerate freezing to some extent. It grows best in winter in plains of India. It attains best color, texture and quality in cool weather conditions. Excessive hot weather, however, causes zoning, the condition which is characterized by the appearance of alternating light and dark red concentric circles in the root. It has been reported that roots develop at a relatively high temperature, having poor color, while those planted in cooler months have excellent color and quality. Beet requires abundant sunshine for development of storage roots. Now let's come to the varieties. A few of the improved varieties popular in India are Detroit Dark Red, Crimson Globe, Early Wonder, Uti One, Crosby Egyptian, Madhur, Ruby Queen and Ruby Red are a few of the varieties marketed by private seed industries. Let's see about the economic importance of beetroot. Beetroot is a popular root crop grown for its fleshy roots, which are used as a cooked vegetable, salad, and pickling and canning. Young plants along with tender leaves are also used as a pot herb. It is very popular in United States of America. Beetroot is a rich source of protein, which has about 1.7 milligram per 100 gram. Carbohydrates, 88 milligram per 100 gram. Calcium, 200 milligram per 100 gram. Phosphorus, 55 milligram per 100 gram. And vitamin C, 88 milligram per 100 gram. Iron, 5 milligram per 100 gram. Vitamin A, 5.1 milligram per 100 gram. Leaves are rich in iron, vitamin A, thiamine, and ascorbic acid, etc. Beetroot can also be eaten as a cooked vegetable and salad. With a high sugar content, it is an ideal ingredient for homemade wine and squash. The root of the sugar beet comprises 75% water, 20% sugar, and 5% fiber. It is also a source of sugar and contribute to the sugar production. Beet sugar is known as sugar derived from sugar beet. Sugar beet, that is beta vulgaris, root comprises a high concentration of sucrose and thus it is mainly grown commercially for beet sugar production, which accounts for 20% of sugar total production. Let's come to cultural practices. The first one is land preparation. Land is brought to a fine tilt by thorough plowing, making it loose and friable. Clods are to be broken or removed completely. Well-decomposed farmyard manure is applied at the time of final plowing. Flat beds or ridges and furrows are prepared for convenient line sowing. Sowing time. Being a cool season crop, beetroot is raised during winter in plains and as a spring or summer crop in the hills by March-April. In plains, sowing is practiced during September to November. Now let's come to the third operation, that is sowing method and spacing. Water-soaked seed bowls, which contains about 2 to 3 seeds, are drilled 2.5 cm deep in rows at a spacing of 45 to 60 by 8 to 10 cm. Staggered sowing at 1 to 2 weeks interval ensures steady supply of roots during the season. In this method, seeds are sown in July and well-developed roots are dug out during November, December. After selection of root tubers, top is trimmed without injuring the crown. Then the whole tubers of selected plants are transplanted in well-prepared fields and irrigated. Cross-pollination is due to self-incompatibility. Now let's see the seed rate. The optimum population is about 1 lakh to 1,20,000 plants per hectare. About 5 to 6 kg of seeds is required for 1 hectare. Now let's come to manures and fertilizer application. Organic manure at the rate of 25 tons per hectare is recommended. For an average soil, 60 to 70 kg nitrogen, 100 to 120 kg P2O5, and 60 to 70 kg K2O per hectare is recommended. Entire farmyard manure, half of nitrogen and full P2O5 and K2O should be applied basally at the time of land preparation prior to sowing, and the remaining quantity at 30 to 45 days after sowing. Nitrate sources of nitrogen are preferred to ammonium sources. Now let's see about water management. Usually, 5 to 6 irrigations are given during summer and 3 irrigations during winter in North Indian plains. Deficiency of water may lead to the reduction in root size. The water requirement of beet has been found to be about 300 mm. This amount should be applied in 5 to 6 irrigations. Now let's see about the weeding and the aftercare. The crop should be maintained weed-free situation up to 75 days. Pratilaclor 50 EC at the rate of 0.5 kg per hectare or pendimethalin at the rate of 3.75 liter per hectare can be dissolved in 300 liters of water and sprayed with hand-operated sprayer on 0 to 3rd day after sowing, followed by hand weeding on 25th day and 50th day after sowing. The earthing up operations coincides with the top dressing of nitrogenous fertilizers. Pre-emergence application of Methamethron 70% AC at the rate of 0.75 kg AI per hectare with Pratilaclor 70% AC at the rate of 0.4 kg AI per hectare, followed by hand weeding on 30 days after sowing. Thinning is an essential operation when more than one seedling germinates from each seed. Swollen roots are also to be covered with soil by earthing up. Hand weeding is usually practiced in India, whereas in advanced countries, mechanical cultivation is commonly employed to control weeds between the rows, and herbicides are used within the rows. Now let's see about the integrated pest and disease management. Seed treatment with Pseudomonas fluorescens at the rate of 10 gram per kg of seed. Summer plowing and exposing the field to sunlight. Crop rotation for 3 years with marigold or gingerly or sun hemp for root, rot and nematodes. Soil application of Trichoderma viridi or Pseudomonas fluorescens at the rate of 2.5 kg per hectare mixed with 50 kg of FIM before planting. Sowing castor as trap crop around and within the fields to attract adult Spodoptera moth for egg laying. Setting up light traps, that is 1 mercury per 5 hectare for monitoring Spodoptera lithura. Setting up pheromone, ferrodin SL at the rate of 12 per hectare for Spodoptera lithura. Remover and destruction of Spodoptera egg masses, early stage larvae form in clusters. Hand picking and destruction of grown up Spodoptera caterpillars are few integrated pest and disease management practices common in the sugar beet crop. Now let's come to the harvesting procedures. Beets are harvested as they attain a diameter of 3 to 5 cm. They are usually pulled by hands. The tops are removed and after washing, the roots are graded according to size. In advanced countries, the mature roots are mechanically harvested, detopped, washed, graded, and finally packed in polythene bags. Removal of tops and packing in polythene bags lengthens the shelf life of beets by reducing water loss during transit and storage. Hence, after harvesting by hand, the dead and injured leaves are removed and then tied in bunches of 4 to 6 beets with their tops on. Harvesting is done 8 to 10 weeks after sowing by pulling up the top with hand. Later, tops are removed, graded, and marketed. In European countries, where small size bunches are in demand, tubers are tied in bundles of 4 to 6 with their tops. Overmatured and oversized tubers become woody and cracked. Post-harvest management. Irrigation should be stopped 15 to 20 days prior to harvest. This allows sugar accumulation. Just after pulling and keeping the tops, it should be stored in a shaded conditions. Roots of sugar beet should reach the factory within 48 hours for processing. Now let's see the yield potential of sugar beet. Yield varies from 25 to 30 tons per hectare and the tuber is stored well at 0 degrees Celsius and 90% relative humidity. Now let's come to the conclusion part of the discussion. Knowledge on the economic use of sugar beet, adaptable climatic situations for growth and development of the crop, the suitable varieties for different agro zones of the country, the cropping system suitable for all the agro climatic conditions, etc., is mandatory for successful production of sugar beet. Sugar beet production and productivity can be enhanced with the use of scientific methods to cope with the climate change and the changing environment. Irrigation system needs priority at the right time and the quantity in view of the erratic rainfall pattern. Since sugar beet is the source of sugar, it has an economic value in the Indian market. Waste of the crop are good cattle feeds in the form of baggages, molasses, etc. Large-scale production of sugar beet would make a chain of sustainability in the Indian economy to make India proud in the face of the world.